Okay, so right here is image we created in previous videos. And if you're interested, I'll post the link below. You can check how it was done with importing, exporting models, doing side view. If you're not so much in 3D, I have a pack available with many different type of backgrounds in this theme, so you can use it. They're prepared and all stuff, but I would recommend to check at least that video about how you can merge HDR image with a normal image, so you receive a little bit more details, just a few step suggestions. But overall, here we're going to use this image, and I'm going to open one that we're going to use it as a practice or as a tutorial follow-up here. If you are Patreon supporters, you will access to this in multiple other packs, including the models we use for free or a heavily discount. So right here is our image. It was shot in a studio, and you can see we have a two light setup. We have a rim light on the side and a deep soft box going from the side as a main light. As a rim light right here, we have a little bit hot spot, so we need to fix this. Before we do this, I want to just point that I'm working with Adobe RGB color space, and we're working with 16-bit color in this case. Okay, so let's go ahead and we'll take our highlights, take them down, so kind of restore some of this information at last. Of course, our skin become a little bit darker overall, and that is okay. We will use it our luminosity on orange channel to bring slightly back up, and you can see we're restoring. Come a little bit back in this area, and let's pop up our sharpness to restore from anti-aliasing high pass filters inside the camera. And also, I want to enable remote chromatic abbreviation and use it profile correction for the cameras. And I think this is all. Next, we'll just go ahead open and the image open inside our Photoshop. So in Photoshop, I want just fix a couple things before we do this. And if I'm looking at my image, the light's kind of almost going from a little bit left side highlights. So I think for this, I want to flip my image. So we'll go to Edit, Transform, Image. And we're going to Canvas. And we're going to transform this flip over. Actually, you know, before flip, let me fix a couple things here. I don't want to do on the original image. We'll just make a copy. And before we do this, I just want to take some of those elements, remove them. So we'll have it reference to original. What have we done before? And to this one right here, just fixed a couple of things. Okay, let's go hide the shadows. And on this point, we got to go edit, transform, flip horizontally. So right here was kind of before and after. I just want to be reference to this. So let's go ahead next. We'll create new layer and we'll call this a retouching layer. Okay, and I'm just set color. This is only reference color, do absolutely nothing to functionality. Next, we'll go to healing brush tool. Let's go closer to her face and just touch up a couple things. Overall, it's look clean and nice. We'll just need to select. And you'll notice what I'm doing. I'm just kind of fixing some of those elements. Not that much. Skin is nice and clean. And I don't want to retouch a lot of details. I want to just, smooth some stuff, because our imperfection, it's what make our look perfect. And I want to keep it some of those imperfection of the skin. So right here, look good. Let's go check arms. The arms look okay right here, just a little bit fixing. Okay, let's go check very fast on the dress if we have anything. We have a little bit wrinkles that we can fix it later. Okay, those wrinkles right here, hair, you see how wide going, it's just a little bit distracting to me, so I'm just going to fix a little bit on this hair. It's not too much, just a little bit remove the distraction out. Okay, let's go check a couple things right here. There you go. Okay, next, what we're going to do it is just moving a little bit. So Control Shift Alt E, Command Option Alt E. It's take all visible layers and combine them by creating brand new. And we'll go call this smoothness. Okay, just smooth. Let's go switch color maybe to the blue on this one. And we'll go to filter. noise, dust and scratches. And in dust and scratches, just overall, it's depend on resolution of your image, but generally you won't see kind of like this, so you don't see small details, but you still see general shape in other ones. And currently maybe even 15 pixels will work better. Let's go ahead, click OK, so it will create this. Next, we'll hold down Alt or Option key and click on a mask. It will create a black mask and hide everything what we have before. So at this point, I want to use my brush. That's 10% opacity, 60% about 6 degrees flow. So it's a soft and nice. And I'm just going brush with white color. Masking kind of create mask. If we look what's happening on a mask, you can see right here I'm just allowed some of that smoothness or removing the noise and scratches come true. So this is will create a little bit more smooth looking skin, a little bit painting kind of effect. I'm avoiding touching on eyes, hair, so I don't want to do this, but these techniques also work very well if you want just smooth down, not necessarily remove it, but just smooth down some of the wrinkles. As well on the scars, for example, I have people who may have it heavy scars or other things, and you don't want to remove those scars all the way because they're what person are, but you want to smooth them. Don't be distraction. This is if you don't want on purpose to have attention to them, then you want to move down. Also with this tool, if you notice right here we have a digital grain, we can very easily remove it. I'll speak about digital grain a little bit later. We will actually need to restore, because if we look closer, we have a digital grain right here, but with a smoothness we are removing this and it will look out of the place. So we're going to add a little bit later back our digital grain to give it all this unity, uniform kind of with everything. So let's zoom out, and on a close sometimes we can little bit using smoothness, but be careful because we have those beautiful decorations, and if we use the smooth we'll lose some detailization. I'm just smoothing just little bit in some of those areas, but avoiding everything else. So right here we're kind of done. Let's go to press Control Alt Shift E Command Option Alt E on a Mac to create again new one. Let's go call its hair, and we're going to filter. We'll go to stylizations, oil painting, and in oil painting, what I want to do is just have it stylization 10, cleanliness 10, scale 0, 1, and a Bristol. We can look how much. We probably don't want to go that high. Let's go Bristol, maybe about 1 set. We want lighting, you can remove it, but lighting give me a little bit of details what I want to keep it. Let's go ahead, click OK. And actually, in some cases, if its lines is not strong enough, we can go to filter, sharpen, and we can use the unsharp mask to bring even stronger effect on this lines. So we won't use this only on a hair. And for this same Alt or Option, click on a mask to hide it. And same soft brush as we're using before, we start brushing in or paint back in some of that hair that we just did. So you can see it is add clean some the noise in a hair. It's what does for us, but as well it's creating this paint effect. So we don't want to be careful because like right here you can see, let's go smaller brush, smaller size. And we'll just reduce right there. I don't want to put this on the gems, but on the hair, yes. And we'll do eyebrows a little bit. If you have a gentleman, for example, with a beard, that will work as well, very well on a beard if you need it. But we can do like right there. Okay, let's go zoom out a little bit. And if we preview, you can see right here before and after, and just a little bit clean up here, make it more as painting type looking. So let's go next, we'll create new layer, and we'll fill this layer with 50% grade, 100% opacity. Let's go click OK and switch to the soft light. This layer will be for us dodge and burn, so it's what we're going to do. And we're going to use the brush with black and white to create additional shadows or highlights. Do recommend again stick around with the capacity, and maybe flow, you know, just to, so remember, we'll just set 60%, so it will be a little bit easy to remember. Okay, now you can see we can brush very slow. And again, if you're using Vicom pen, it's very nice and useful in this case. So you can just pressure sensitive. Because I'm using mouse, I like to set my settings very soft. So I can use it multiple clicks and just add very soft. I'm try to avoid any dramatic kind of look. So I'm trying to create this soft add. Okay, let's go to nose closer. Just add a little bit spot right here. Okay, actually, you know what? Let's go to add maybe 80% on the flow. Little bit faster and more. And we'll just add highlights. You know, add a little bit smaller right there. Okay, there you go. Let's add on the lips. Just a little bit of volume on the lips. And the volume is what's happening when we black and white or luminosity, it's what give it a shape. Color does not provide necessary shape. It provides some information, but most shape of the objects or image in 2D, it's coming from luminosity, from the black and white. And it's what we're doing. We're using black and white just to shape it as we need it, our object. Okay, so I'm going right here, just add a little bit more line. Okay, let's go switch to black color and add a little bit more shadowing. Okay, right here. Let's zoom out. Okay, we'll add a little bit down, and usually I'm going a little bit lower right here. So we don't worry, just go a little bit over the model because we are going to use it compositing on this. Okay, let's zoom out and we'll just check before and after. You can see we'll just add a little bit more volume, a little bit more dimension to this. Okay, so let's go ahead, Control Shift Alt Command Option Alt E on a Mac to create new layer. And this is Global Dodge and Burn or Detailization. So that's what we're going to do. For this, we go to Image Adjustment. We'll go to Black and White. And I'll bring back a little bit red and like right there, a little bit of red, a yellow, a little bit higher. Click OK. Image Adjustments. And we're going now to Shadow Highlights. If you see like this menu, just check Show More Options. It will expand and give you access to more options for the shadow and highlights. We want to put it amounts for highlights and shadows to 100%, and let's set radius to 10 pixels on both of them. Next, we'll give it tone, bring a little bit down on the darkness, because we're going to use this in a soft light mode. With 50% gray will be invisible, and whatever darker will kind of emphasize darker and highlights as well. So that's what we're doing. We're just adding a little bit more highlights and dark to this area, but also we'll have a detailization, because if we look closer, we'll add more details to this. For that, let's go to sharpen as well on same layer, and we'll just add a little bit more sharpness to this. Let's go switch this to the soft light, and as an example, you can see right here, look on the detailizations before and after. So it does increase, but overall texturing pop up a little bit, but I think it's a little bit too strong. So let's go ahead, take our opacity, and we'll drag and drop maybe to about 20%. So at this moment, I want to take all of this, group them together. Let's go call it model, right click and convert to smart object, because we're going to move this smart object inside our background, what we created, and smart object, that way I can scale, adjust and whatever without affecting inside the pixels. And again, this is before and after. Okay, so let's go ahead, take our smart object and move to our background. Now we're going to proceed, just click and drop in. Okay, take a few seconds. Right here, you can see it's a little bit smaller, which is okay. We can press Control Command T and scale. And I just want to scale like right there. One thing usually I can put on the ground, but we don't have it very close. So because of that, I'm going to cut off a little bit. Well, maybe like around here. I think that way will be nice. And we always can play a little bit more. And just actually, you know what, let's bring up and we'll start working. We'll go to create a new mask. And before switching, let me show you. So here is our overlay mode. So we have overlay, soft light, another one. So we'll go with a normal, but we'll go and use it our brush, black color, and we're going to paint in all of that stuff. Actually, we don't want self one normal. So we're going to actually paint in. But before we'll do this, one small thing I want to do. It's click on a color for the our foreground, and we'll just go in and select maybe around gray color. You know what? Let's go to probably about 40% right here in the gray. Let's go ahead, click OK. And if we set 200% and start paint, we know it will be exactly the same everywhere. So we can just go over very roughly around here, like right there, just to preview, see if it will look okay on the sizes. This is all what we're doing. We'll just resizing, and we'll come closer in a second, like right there. I just want to be sure it is look around there. So let's go ahead. We'll put here a little bit below, like right there. I think this way will look nicer. And we'll, if we draw a line below, you can see we have it better compositions. Of course, if you need it, Command Control T, we can rescale. Maybe even put it like right there, a little bit bigger. Maybe this one will work better. You can play around a little bit more with the sizes on this, but we are a little bit easier on this because we have it. But normally what I take from this line, if we try, maybe just a little bit like right there. There you go. Okay, so when we're done, let's go now work a little bit better on the mask. And for this one, we'll go switch back to black color. On the mask, we'll go to 10%. Let's go zoom closer to her hair. And we'll start right there. We can kind of can go closer run her hair to blend in. And technically this is not necessary overlay mode. I just call this to distinguish, because many cases what I do, I'm just using pen tool or select by color or otherwise. But with these ones, it feels like it does using kind of more softer blend between model and other, and it's helped me to and distinguish type. Okay, right here we have also a little bit semi-transparency. We can actually even add a little bit more transparency to her outfit right there, so we can see. Okay, let's go closer. Okay, and the one thing you notice, we did a rim light. And rim light, as we shot, was a little bit behind her, and this was done on purpose because her clothes, it's a translucent, semi-transparent, so in that way, it will make them glow when we're using rim light. Okay, so let's go right there. Okay, right there, a little bit more blending around here. And we have it some cyanish color. We need to rework to blending on that color there in. Okay, right there. Okay, we have it, oops, wrong. We need to reduce. Add a little bit. There you go. Let's go on our hair. And we have it a little bit more to rework. We'll look on this in a second, how we can do easier way. I'm just very roughly going right now around her hair. Okay, right here will be kind of a little bit more tricky because we have a brighter moon and we need to be careful. But with these techniques, it's also allowed us to almost add a glowing to her hair. So you can see what's happening. So because moon produces glowing, and we can just slightly touch up and create this glowing effect. Okay, let's go closer to her hand, right between and on the edge. These ones will be the hardest parts, and you can use it maybe even harder too. So if you have a problem, you can select with the pen, or you can have it like hard edge and just going with hard edge. But if you do with hard edge, what you want to do, see how it's created those points. We don't want those points creating, so we can just click on mask, alt or option, click there, select the color and select the color that we want to keep it. Okay, so that way, again, alt, whatever we're doing, we'll just keep it same all over the place, so we won't go too much in different color. But that way we can have it hard edge, and we can just going a little bit like right there by her arm. Okay, and if you have it zero, there you go, you can see you can kind of like going around same as other ones. Well, I don't need that hard, it's just suggestion, so you can do. Oops, again, I'm still be on a zero. I need on 10%, but I like a little bit glowing effect, and it's nice we have moon there because it will help us to create this glowing effect around our subject without kind of stepping out. I'm going on 20%, a little bit faster. Okay, right here we'll go arm a little bit more. It does help if your backdrop similar color, because many times when I shoot, it will be probably around 50% gray, so it can be blend anything. This is, you can see, it was kind of cyan color backdrop, so it's have it some limitations, and we'll need it a little bit more work with the color if we want a seamless view. But even with these techniques, okay, let's go 20%, a little bit faster again. And by the way, if you need change very fast colors, just press 1, 2, or 3 number, and this will help you to very fast work with the colors to change. Okay, we have it semi-transparent, which is help us because now we can, don't worry too much about edge. We actually want to go a little bit over the edge, so we're creating look through that semi-transparent cloth right there. Okay, yeah, let's look a little bit closer. Right here we have it rework. Okay, now if we press on alt and a mask, you can see we have our mask showing us, so this is very helpful because now we can also select the necessary color with, because this color, and we can actually just add right there by the edge. Actually, this is a little bit too bright. Let's go a little bit darker. There you go. Okay, right there we can going by the mask. And we can create it right around there. Same around her hair. Let's go increase in size. There you go. Okay. Overall, by doing this, we can see spots that we miss it or we want to redo it. And let's go click Alt again. And there you go. There's our mask right here. I think I did not come closer. You can definitely see coloring right here. So we'll go. Let's paint. Okay. There you go. So we have it little bit better on this coloring. Okay, let's go zoom out. And if you see somewhere pop up, we can always come back and retouching. But overall, I think it's look okay, except right there, see where the light? We need smooth this. This is not smooth enough. So we'll just need it a little bit remove to create uniform. We don't want to have it 100% white, but we want to create a little bit closer to that. Okay, let's zoom out. Okay, a little bit on a hair maybe add. And then you can see with the hair on the edge, it's blending very well with the background. So it's work very good here. And we have a little bit glowing. Okay. We'll add slightly glowing to her face in a second. Same as on a hand. And on a hand, we can just go right a little bit even more to the edge. I just see a little bit darkness. I want just kind of remove some of that. Okay, yeah, that's look better. Okay, we have a nice, beautiful rim light from blue. We need a cast and warm color going from the side. So let's go ahead. Next, we'll start kind of adding a little bit more, I think, rim to lights to her face. To do this, let's go press Control on a mask. So we'll selecting kind of mask on a person. We'll go create a new layer. And we'll just select blue color right here, just Alt or Option, click on the blue and fill up with the same color. Okay, let's go to next, select, modify contract, and let's contract it by 4 pixels. Okay, and delete it. So what is happening, if we look right here, we should have just this blue color outline. Okay, actually, you know what, Control Z, let's undo, Control Z again, or Command Z. So actually what we want to do, we want to select it, sorry. We need a rim, we don't need it. Let's delete this one, create new. Okay, we'll go to fill up with a color, what we have it. And you notice that because it's not absolutely black, we have a problem is light leaking, so it's apply everywhere. We don't necessarily want to do this, so we want to apply just to her rims. Lights on this case, these techniques maybe won't work. So we'll go to different way. And different, we'll just create new layer. Let's go call it so rim light. Switch to the soft light. And then in case, if we don't have a clear mask, we always can do this way. So we already have it lights we selected. Now we can go closer to her face. Right here, and using with soft light, actually you can go and increase a little bit better on saturations. We can just start on the rims painting right there. So remember there's a reflection kind of going on your hand, a little bit right there. Okay, let's go right in the elbow. And if we look, that will kind of give it us a little bit more of the color of the night. There you go. Okay, a little bit right there. One thing, if we look on the light, we kind of going over in some areas, so we need to be careful with this, how we're painting. Okay, let's create a small mask and we'll just hide some of this, reducing a little bit this when again over border with that. You can always try to select by subject and it will work in many cases. Actually with Photoshop does a very good job on that one. I just don't want to use it in case if you have an older version of Photoshop. So then you don't need to worry about selecting by subject. Okay, right here. And we have a nice overlay. Okay, so let's go ahead and add a little bit warmer to our other side. So we'll create a new layer. Well, let's go call warm, rim warm color. We'll switch to soft light as well. And in this case, what I want to do is switch from this to a little bit more warm orangey color. And we'll just go right here in the middle. So instead there, we'll just add coloring slightly on her dress. Right there. Don't worry if it's too strong. We'll fix in the middle, but okay, right there, a little bit on her hand. What I want to do is creating this cold, warm kind of look. Okay, right there. And now we can take this opacity and take it down and just bring slightly up. We don't need too much, just maybe around there. Okay, so at this moment, we have it, our image done. Let's add slightly behind her. So what I want to do is add a little bit glowing around this area, more like moon. For this, we'll go create new layer. We have a dodge and burn. It's meaning we'll move to soft light type. And let's go rename this dodge and burn. We'll take our brush. Be sure it is set black and white, 10% soft. We'll start with darker color, with the black. And notice this is will apply to everything, not just to the model, because it's over everything. So we'll go like right there. We'll add moon kind of glowing on her a little bit. Right there, maybe. And I'm using X key to go from brighter and darker. Kind of give it this warm color, warm, cold color. Let's go create new layer. And for this one, same, we'll switch to soft light. I still want to play a little bit more with the coloring. So I still want to create this kind of cold color and cast right there, just over this blue area. Okay, and we'll have it warm color just to cast around here. Just a little bit playing with those, you know, two colors that will give it a nice, nice feel. Again, we don't need that strong. Let's reduce it. Okay. Next, let's add a little bit of elements that will help us bring a little bit together everything. And for this, we'll use it white. We'll use it brush 100%. And I'm going to use it Ron smoke. Actually, you know what? Let's go with the Ron fog, probably these ones. Okay, we'll go select fog element, and you can see like right there just which one we can select it. So let me try different ones. This one maybe work better. Okay, you can see when we click, it's created one, so I'm not necessarily want that. We'll go to the brush tool. And in a brush tool, what we wanted, it is go shape dynamics. We want increase a little bit on size changing. Let's go switch on angle, go randomness, add on adjusting here. We'll go to scattering, add little bit, not too much on the scattering count. And that right there. So now if you notice, when we start painting, it just will create randomly for us. And for this one, I just want to create a little bit, like right there, maybe smoke a little bit on the arms, kind of help us blend stuff together. Okay, maybe, you know, even let's go with the larger stuff. Don't worry if it's too much. We will fix it in a second, this, but it does, if you can see, kind of help us. We'll be blending. So let's go switch to the soft light on this. Okay, now on the soft light, you can see we just add a little bit this grungy, which is kind of bring everything together. And a little bit softness around there. Okay, next, let's go create new layer. And call it fog, cast colors. Okay, and this one is will be our grain. You remember what I said before, because we're using different elements and some of them have a grain. If we come closer, you can see like her armor, we have a grain, but we don't have any grain on this image. So we want to kind of bring them together with that. And for this, we'll go create grain. So we'll go fill up with 50% gray. We'll go to filter noise and go to add noise. Probably about 15% should work for this. It's monochrome type of the grain and switch to the soft light. Okay, let's come closer and we'll see now. You can see the grain kind of help us merging together by unifying. If it's too much, we can reduce. Next, let's go to add a little bit on the coloring for this. And I'll have two coloring. One, I'm going to use the Filter Forge. And the Filter Forge, it's an app, but you can have a 30 days free trial. But all filters, it's, I forget, like 16,000, is a huge amount of filters, they're all free. And I'm just using filter that I created, phototone, which helped me very fast kind of created adjustment color on this. Again, it's a free, you can download it. But you can see just with a few adjustments, I can kind of creating the mode I want here. I think that one will work good. 51, and we'll just apply to this. It's all what it does, it's apply coloring overlay. You can do probably with just the color curves and luminosity curves, so we can do a similar things effect. All what it does is just save a little bit time for me to go and create this that way. And again, just slightly color overlay, maybe a little bit too strong, let's reduce it. But you always can go and create like selective colors, as example. And in selective colors, we can go same. We can just reduce a little bit crush black, add yellow, a little bit green for the black and cyan. You can see actually red look nice as well, but we'll go a little bit with cyanish. But on the neutrals, opposite, we'll just add a little bit more yellowishy and reddish. So we'll just create a little bit warmer. And we're going with this color. The shade is will be darker, cold, about one like right there. And other ones will be brighter and warm. So we'll just go with those colors. As well, we have it white color. So right there, but white, we want just the same. Add a little bit warmer on the white color as well. Okay, so let's go ahead. Next, we'll add curve. And this curve will just take all the way down. Select the rectangle marquee tool. Go from almost from the corner, but not all the way. Create a frame and fill this frame with black color. Next, we'll go to the curves with the masking for our. We'll go feathering and bring feathering all the way. This is just create for us dynamic vignetting in a soft light mode, which is can just help give it attention a little bit on our model at this mode. Okay, so let's go close it. Next things, let's add a little bit of glow. Actually, I put this under selective colors and I'm just hiding these two layers for now. Just after above filter forge, let's create control shift alt E, command option alt E, new one. We'll just create a glow level, just add a little bit more glowing to this. So for this, we'll go to image adjustment, actually filter blur, and let's go to the Gaussian blur. So we'll add a little bit of the blur to that, like maybe about 4750. For the my image, yours it could be different. Just be sure you kind of look like this, and we'll go to switch to the screen. Can see right here we don't need that much glow, so let's go ahead, alt or option, hold and click on a mask to hide, take our brush tool, let's switch the soft round brush. Okay, and for this brush we want to be sure it is set to the 10% opacity. Okay, let's go switch to the white color, come closer, and now we can brush just in some areas where we want this a little bit glowing going on. So like around her arm, around moon, like right there. So it's where the glowing happens. Okay. Let's go zoom out. There you go. Just a little bit, maybe right here, glowing on your face. If it's too much, you again can switch to the black color and just reduce some of that glowing in some areas if you need it. Here's our mask for the glowing. And of course, if you think otherwise, you can always use it opacity just to reduce it in general. Okay, let's go back and enable our colors. And this is what we have. So we can go to select all. Let's go call it edit. And there we have it, our model before that was shot. Actually, this one will be before. This one is a background that we're using. Actually, this is tone mapped background, but that is what we use, the non-tone mapped background. And here's our image that we combine all together and creating this look. The last step, what you need to do is just go click on the middle and type your name. Usually I don't type, it's up to you what you prefer. I like to type my name kind of small down and use it very small opacity. So it's kind of, you can see it. It's there, but it's not in your face and does not take all of your attention. So like around here, maybe just on the middle, and you know, 4%, maybe even higher. Let's go to about 3%. So you can see it still be there. People can see if needed, but it does not take attention from our image. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you find it educational and at least inspirational to you to create your own. If you are Patreon supporters, the packs with the background will be available for you as well. I'll put a bonus, some photos of the models that you can play around and adjust this, as well as a video tutorials. If you're not Patreon supporters, you can purchase the packs on the Gumroad and Geekatplay, or in become Patreon and get it, most of those packs for free or for heavily discount. Again, thank you very much for all your support. It's kind of helped me to keep on going and creating new content for you. Have a fun time to creating your own.